when you first get here, the city, it just hits you
to see these masterpieces that we've all learned about in classes.
Being able to see what came before you, to really experience it and be a part of it.
You walk by the Duomo, you walk by these, you know, colossal like figures of the Renaissance.
Kind of scrambles your mind to think about how many layers we're existing in, and then we're just another thing on top of that.
To work in a city that's basically a huge art hub of both the past and the contemporary, and us trying to find our way within the two.
Everybody kind of has to struggle with a fight for their relevance, for purpose.
There's a clash between, you know, the old world and the present. But I wouldn't say it's a violent clash.
I think it's a really good place, actually, to kind of start to form yourself as a contemporary artist, being around all of this history. I think it actually helps a little bit that it's not so overwhelmingly contemporary here, because it allows you to feel like there's more of a space for you, that you can go out there and do your work.
Making contemporary work, or making work that's not in a traditional or classical form, in a place that has this very traditional legacy, I find that that creates room for dialogue.
Is actually really liberating, and it actually helps you to be, I think, a little bit more honest in the way that your work goes. Instead of trying to fit into what's happening, you can just respond in a really natural way.
It is difficult, but it allows you to really kind of grasp what you're doing and the reasoning behind it.
Certainly getting your MFA anywhere would be just life-changing, but having that also be in a new culture, you have to respond to more, you have to adapt more, deal with so much more change that wouldn't happen if you were in the US.
You have to learn how to work with other people from different cultures and backgrounds. You have to respect that and understand that.
Most people don't necessarily speak Italian, and so it's you have to be open-minded about learning Italian too, and, you know, tripping over yourself when you try to say things, and just kind of, I think being in this different culture helps you open yourself a little bit too.
Acclimating to so many different things, and it's like you have to go buy supplies in a language that you're not fluent in. Little things like that, I mean, are sort of, can make your head spin at first, and it's hard to orient yourself.
Once you process it, I think you become more grounded than you would somewhere else where it's easier to be.
Well, I think everyone comes in with an initial, this is what I want to do and this is how I would like to do it, but ultimately that's going to be changed because your inspirations, collaboration, everything, it evolves.
When you first get here, that's all you know. We didn't even know each other yet, so all we knew was what our work was like. And then our work started changing. So what does that mean? I mean, that means you're changing. That's kind of scary, because it happens really quickly here.
I think we all came with an idea, and it was something completely different. So much more than what we originally thought. This course has allowed me to grow in ways I didn't think would be possible.
What I didn't expect is to be where to transform in the way that I did. Just looking at my work today, it's like I don't think me 2 years ago would have even paid attention.
I wasn't really prepared for how much growth. I feel like it's been more of an intimate experience being the first group we grew.
Yeah, the way people are when they first get here, and it's confusing, and, you know, you're kind of scattered because you're traveling and you're embarking upon a new chapter in your education at the same time. The way that you're feeling from 1 week to the next is going to be different.
You can't hide from that. If it changes, if you start responding differently to things, then it's going to bring out stuff that's not so easy to deal with all the time. I think that's something we've all gone through here, and something that has ended up really rewarding for everyone. I mean, it is. It's scary, though, right?
because it's very personal. You know, as artists, we expose ourselves greatly. Art is this endless process of discovery, you know, self-investigation.
You just, you don't know how much you can change until you do.
What's great about SACI is they allow us to take classes outside of our discipline, and I think most of us found other ways we like to express ourselves in unison with painting.
The program is very much about developing your concept of who you are, knowing yourself better, that goes along with your art, which is a little bit more than I was expecting, I guess.
I think we were able to see a lot of things that I never would have got to see going to Berlin and London and things like this.
We were able to obtain, I believe, a lot of new knowledge that we couldn't have if we would have gotten our degree somewhere else.
That's one of the things I didn't realize either, was how different approaching art from a European perspective is. You never realize, living in the United States, growing up in the United States, how close in proximity everything is.
You have this mobility that you might not have again, because this is a very special, concentrated time period.
That's the great part of this program. It gives you the time, it gives you the opportunity, the networking.
Going to the art fairs and having being able to experience the Biennale.
We went to Frieze in London, we went to Berlin, you know, we went to the art fair in Bologna. We've been exposed to so much.
It's incredible the fact that we can say we've done these things, along with these amazing professors and other fellow students that you're collaborating with that are helping you grow. And I think when the two emerge together, I mean, you can't ask for anything better than that.
The professors are very good at getting to know you and know really what is going to be very beneficial for you and pushing you outside of your comfort zone, not just to push you out there, but in a direction that is going to be helpful for you.
Even if you're not in one of their classes, they're really generous with their time and their knowledge, and they really care, and they're excited if you're excited.
They'll talk and they'll talk and they'll talk, and then they'll just say three words that change your life forever.
I look at different qualities now. I dig deep into the work. I found my own way, my own language of creating art that's unique to me.
It's hard to imagine when I didn't think that way, but I know at some point I didn't. And now that I do, I would never want to change that. If you start really thinking deeply about everything that you're experiencing and putting that into your work, then some really difficult questions about life are going to come up. But I think that's also the point.
You gotta be open, and you gotta be able to adapt. And you can't have all these notions of entitlement or anything like this. Like, you gotta work hard and not expect anything.
Embrace and adapt and to grow through all these challenges.
That was one of our strongest points with everybody. We all adapted. We left this idea of being visitors and tourists. We became part of the community more, like, and we became integrated into culture.
We're leaving now with so much more, because we're leaving now with a culture. We're almost integrated now as part of the Italian culture.
Like, I expected to always feel like an outsider, and that changed. And that was incredible. You know, we're here for 2 years, and so it's different. You're not here to just see the way people live. You're here to live alongside them.
It's not necessarily a belonging in a location, it's a belonging in yourself, you know?
I see a lot of us going forward and being very international artists after having this exposure of this education here. I expect a lot of us to take advantage of that, and I expect a lot of success from us as a group.
I'm really excited to see what everybody does.
Whether we become professors or artists, whatever, I think we're gonna help other people a lot.
10, 15 years from now, we will all be doing great things with our lives. Whether it be teaching, having our own practice, a curator in a museum.
All of us are on such different paths, and I think it's just we need to continue on those paths and see where it leads us.
Use this experience as a formula for succeeding in a new place.
Keep creating and keep pushing.
I just want to tell everybody to keep on dreaming and keep on working hard.
I hope everybody always feels as connected to their work as we did here. What's happened here because of that has been incredible.
I think it's probably one of the best experiences of my life, and probably for all of us.
I thought it would be like, oh, my art will get much better, but at some point I started realizing that my whole world would change.
I hope that it's been a positive experience or a transformative experience for everyone. But I also don't see any way that it could not be, you know, because we all changed our lives to come here.
I don't know if I ever would have done this if I didn't do it this time in my life to come here and get this perspective.
I honestly don't think I would be the individual that I am today without being here in Florence.
It's the best decision I ever made, absolutely.
My name is Danielle Schaefer.
Jessica Danes.
Horacio Lizardo Jr.
Christina Gednalske.
Molly DiGrazia.
Gwyneth Aldis.
Walker Keith Jernigan.
Rada Rose Tague.